Hello everybody, I'm Andy Atoman and this is Russ Miller from the MAPEX booth here at NAMM 2019. Russ is going to talk to us about this lovely kit that's behind us.
It's a system of drums that's designed to be at the forefront, push innovation, try things we haven't tried before, and there's all kinds of those moments in both of the kits. There's two kits. One's called a cherry bomb, it's made of cherry. One's called a versatus, that's Latin for versatile. This is very hi-fi, it's maple mahogany. This one is cherry, all cherry shells. And we do some things that haven't been done before and some new twists on things too. So for instance, some new twists on things. We have chamber specific designs, right? So a lot of times you buy a drum set and the 10 sounds great, 14 sounds great, 12's like, I don't know, 16 maybe not. A lot of that is because a lot of times the designers try to force the same plies and thicknesses into every tom, right? It's cheaper to do that, of course. So we do a chamber-specific design. So every drum is tested for what's best for that size. That means the thickness of the wood, the edges change, the hoops change, the positioning of the different woods and the hybrid shells change. So like say the softer woods are at the contact point on the head for bigger drums, so it's drier. We have a ring system that we use to change the sound where rings are on the top, bottom only, double rings, three rings, everything changes. Some drums have rings, some have up to three rings. So it's all about getting every drum to be the best instrument it can possibly be. Everybody's been talking about this. This is a revolutionary approach that Randall May International and the design team for Design Lab worked on. It's called the MAAT system, M-A-A-T-S. Stands for Magnetic Air Adjustment Tom Suspension. And the drums float on a magnetic field. It's never been done before. Basically, if you played a drum and you hold it up and you tune it and you hit it, it sounds great, put it on the mount, it gets all choked up because it's losing vibration transfer through the hardware. The shell's bearing its own weight. So what we wanted to do is remove all of the weight of the shell off of the bearing its own weight, right? So what we've done is we've got magnets to bear the weight of the drum. This thing sort of dangles like when you're hitting a drum. It's not attached at all to the hardware. You can see the whole thing is sort of just pivoting on this leverage point. This just decides what size drum, 18 down here or 8 at the top. And then the magnets hold the weight. Very simple. You can see it floating in there. But what's really amazing, after we started to do it, I did a lot of testing. And we realized that by changing the magnet force back and forth, you can adjust the sound of the drum by using the mount. So as you put less or more magnets in it, the drum sound gets longer or shortens. And you don't need any more tape or moon gels or rings, anything like that, because those affect the feel and the sound at the same time. This way you can have a wide open drum, feels great, but it's shorter. So that's never been done before. One of the other things that's amazing as a player, it feels great. You can hear it's a really full, long, open sound. It's wide open, but it's not out of control. It's not ringing like crazy.
I can see the magnet moving when he hits it.
Yeah, it moves it just a tiny bit. And you can control the sound of that by adjusting the magnet again. And so that's that. But we also did, that's for high toms, of course. But for floor toms, we wanted to do the same thing. So one of the things with floor toms, and again, you're going to say, I can't believe we haven't done this before. But the straighter the leg is on a floor tom, the worse the drum sounds, to make it very simple.
Sure.
Like if my floor toms would feed back in big venues, I used to take my floor tom leg out and put it upside down, and it would shorten the sustain of the drum because it's getting the vibration of the floor quicker. So the best sound of a floor tom has like about a 90 degree leg like this. So we have 90 degree static legs that don't move. But we decided to test if we could create a fully adjustable floor tom leg. So you can change the angle of the leg and adjust the sound of the floor tom. So no more muffling on the floor tom. So if it's ringing too much, you just straighten it out a little bit, all the way to straight or even inverted like Sonor does. And it changes the sound of the floor tom in real time. There's a couple other things that are really important. One of them is the aux drum. It's a 3-in-1 instrument. It's a gong bass drum like you see it there. It comes with the mounting to do that, but it also comes with the floor tom legs to make it an additional floor tom. And it also comes with the spurs to make it a bass drum. You can put a pedal on the hoop. So it's a 3-in-1 thing, and that's why we call the drum kit Versatus, which means versatile, because when you get this set up, you can make 5 different drum kits.
So
There's one last thing I want to tell you about that's really interesting, and hopefully everybody will grab onto it. No one has ever really discussed what the finishes of the drums do to the sound. So we actually have a system that we've developed called the SAS finish system, stands for Sonic Clear Attenuating Finish System. And what we came to realize through a lot of testing is there's three different levels to this finish. There's four different levels. There's a zero, a one, two, and a three. A zero means that the finish does not affect the sound. So if you look at the Cherry Bomb kit here, it's on a satin finish. That's a zero finish. It sounds the same without a finish on as it does with. But when you get to one of these finishes, which is a high gloss, this actually raises the pitch a third of an octave and shortens the sustain by 20%, right? Then when you get to a veneer that has an additional wood layer, it raises it by another third of an octave and shortens by another 20%. So we're discussing you picking the finish of the drums by how you want it to sound. No one's ever done that before, but you probably experienced things like if you're a jazz player and you want to tune them real high, you might get a natural finish because that's something you would want as a jazz drummer. But the natural finish has the lowest fundamental. So you're tuning it way out of the range of the drum. So if you want to tune it into a higher range, we recommend using the veneers and the high glosses that raises the pitch almost an octave and a half naturally.
But again, it seems one of those things so obvious to do. I know as a guitar player that people talk about the finishes on a guitar changes the tone.
They do the same thing, yeah.
So it's amazing to know it's happening in the drum world.
Of course, yeah. And no one's really ever talked about it. Obviously, we're not inventing that. They just never really talked about it. Huh. So we developed the whole finish range system all the way up to three. A three is a wrap, which is plastic wrap, which really affects the sound, of course. But it's amazing. I mean, we have demonstrations where we take the same shell and literally it's like boom, 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 like same shell with four different finishes.
Well, Russ, I know that our guy over in Germany at Thomann, Addy, is super excited about this new system.
Oh, great.
And he told me I absolutely had to make time to come and see you.
Okay.
And I'm so glad that I did.
Well, I'm glad you did as well.
It's been wonderful talking to you.
It's a
Thank
pleasure.
You so much.
We'll see you guys back in Europe again. Great. I love getting over there.
So a little message to you guys watching this, all the drummers, hello, firstly, and goodbye, I guess. Thank you so much for your time, Russ. We're at NAMM 2019 we're changing the world of drums, aren't we?
We're fixing drumming. That's what we're doing.